Democrats in the Senate, in fact, all 11 Democrats on the Senate Judiciary Committee, are not happy with Supreme Court Chief Justice John Roberts' excuse for not coming in and talking to them about the blatant corruption of Justices Clarence Thomas and, of course, as we learned this week, Neil Gorsuch. And so these 11 Democrats sent a letter with some questions that they would like John Roberts to answer, basically saying, like, if you're not going to come in here and answer our questions, perhaps you'd prefer to do it from the comfort of your own home and you can write them down and just send them back at your leisure. But the reason the Democrats are doing this is because in his rejection letter that he sent to the Senate, where he's like, yeah, I'm not coming in, he mentions something that has actually raised a lot of questions with those Democrats in the Senate. He said, hey, listen, there's a code of ethics for the lower courts, not for the Supreme Court. But I assure you, you know, our Supreme Court, like, we subscribe to that as well. Now, if you subscribe to something, just so everybody knows, like, you can cancel a subscription at any time. So that's not actually what the Democrats wanted to say, but I just wanted to point that out because he didn't say we strongly adhere to them. We go by that same code. He's like, we subscribe to it too. You know, until it's inconvenient, then we just unsubscribe. So the Democrats shot back in the letter saying this. The statement of principles raises more questions than it resolves, and we request that you respond to several key questions. For example, if you go by the same code of ethics that the lower federal courts have to go through, quote, what is the consequence, if any, for a sitting justice who does not respond as appropriate to such a letter of inquiry? So they're not even trying to, like, put it on Clarence Thomas and Neil Gorsuch. They're like, all right, if you subscribe to that code of ethics, right, you do know that if we send a letter of inquiry to these folks, they're legally obligated to respond to it. And we've sent a letter of inquiry to you. So you tell us what happens to those lower court judges when they don't answer the questions. I think that's that's a gut punch. That was pretty damn good. Look, I'm hard on Democrats, rightfully so. But I gotta tell you, putting that out there in the ether, being like, all right, tough guy, you adhere to this code of ethics. What happens to those guys if we ask them questions and they don't answer? Yeah, they get in trouble. But why don't you tell us that? Because you said you follow the same rules. And thereby, if you do not answer that question, then we're going to assume that you're going to hold yourself to the same standard that those other judges would be held to if they refused to answer questions from us senators. Pretty big gotcha question there. Another question is, what types of penalties have been or may be imposed? Is there a process by which the public may file and the Supreme Court may receive complaints that a justice has failed to abide by these principles? The Democrats, again, to their credit, they're kind of going pretty hard against this guy. And I love it because the public needs this. John Roberts is an absolute coward for not showing up in front of that Senate and answering those questions. Now, the Supreme Court is not like the Senate. It's not like John Roberts is going to be stripped of being the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court if he loses a conservative majority. Like, he was appointed as Chief Justice. He's Chief Justice. Like, he could be the only conservative on that court, and he's still going to be the leader of the court. So what do you care, dude? I mean, you obviously have your ideology that you want to push on the rest of the country, which is why you don't want to get rid of the corruption on your own court. But yeah, aside from that, why not answer the questions? Why not let the public know what the hell is going on? But most importantly, why not let the public know that you're not doing a damn thing about any of this corruption? Because that's what's happening to Roberts Court. It is falling apart. It is crumbling from within because these justices are so corrupt and so unaccountable that the public has absolutely no faith whatsoever in them anymore. And the Democrats are trying to get answers, and Republicans would love for the whole story to just disappear. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.